Mr. and Mrs. Kumagai pay their respects to the victims of the tsunami. He lost 11 family members when the wall of water swept away much of this coastal town, along with scores of other communities. He and his wife were among the lucky ones.
夢中になって、まあ、逃げたんですよ。で、高台に逃げて、そして見たら自分の家が、その家が押し寄せてきて壊れる。それから車がもう浮いて、どんどんどんどん寄せてくる。雨の落ちたっていうか、それはね、ものすごい高いものでしたんで、まあ、自分たちの想像っていうかつくようなもんじゃなかったですね。
Life for them now in their temporary house is a little cramped and not as active as they would like. But the support they've received from both within Japan and abroad, including a package of 6 domestic appliances from the Red Cross Red Crescent, helps them to be as comfortable as possible. The landscape here 1 year after the disaster presents a mixed picture. With most of the debris cleared, but much remains to be done. There are clear signs of recovery, even though permanent homes have not yet been rebuilt. But there is also still desolation. The survivors of the tsunami continue to live with the emotional aftermath of the disaster. It takes time and effort to knit together a new sense of community in the temporary housing settlements. Many of those here benefit from psychosocial support as they face the many new challenges of their daily lives. Sometimes they are not aware of how much stress they face until they try to relax.
家だけじゃなくて仕事も失って結局 あまりに失うものが多すぎてとても前に進むまでに気持ちが切り替えれないそういうところで心のケアが必要だと思います。
The Japanese Red Cross Society, with its strong focus on medical care, was in the forefront of the treatment of the nearly 100,000 survivors. Now, much of the health infrastructure in the disaster area is operating out of prefabricated buildings, with all the problems that brings with it. So the Red Cross Red Crescent is working, with the help of donations received from all over the world, to ease the burden on these clinics by building new hospitals, both permanent and temporary, the first of which are now nearing completion.
診療所はですね、1日200人の患者さんが来るということで、それから診察室も狭い、患者さんの待ち合いも狭いということで、それとあと衛生面で水も来てない、仮設の、トイレも仮設だということで、どうしてもここの場で長いことこの診察するにはちょっと患者さんに負担がかかるということで、それと本設まで3年から5年かかるということもございまして、日赤さんの補助をもらって仮設の診療所を建てることにしています。
今日午後3時半過ぎに。
Just one day after the earthquake and tsunami, there is alarming news from the Fukushima nuclear plant. Very soon, a 20-kilometer exclusion zone is declared around the plant.Residents are only allowed back inside for brief visits under medical supervision. Among the treasured possessions which Mrs. Yamada and her daughter retrieved on a visit to their home near the plant are mementos of Mrs. Yamada's husband, who died a few months before the disaster. While they feel sadness at the loss of their way of life, there is also anger.
戻りたいんですけど、放射能がそういう痛み。戻れないので残念です。
避難指示があって避難したところが放射能が高いということでということが後で分かりました。
People need to have more information and be better prepared, not just for natural disasters, but also for this kind of eventuality. We are taking the lead in getting our international partners together to draw up new guidelines on preparedness for nuclear accidents.
But for now, many mothers, even in Fukushima City, some 70 kilometers away from the nuclear plant, are not about to let their children play outdoors. There are too many questions and not enough answers about the long-term health impact of the radiation they might be exposed to. Until these questions are answered, this new Red Cross indoor playground provides a rare chance for parents to put their worries aside and watch their children play in safety.